One more question. I'm involved in all this. Yeah, I decided. I've made my mind, for example, to turn into this Kriya Yoga practice. Do you have a kind of a book or something that unites all the practice, all the this? For example, Bible or Quran or something.
So, in the Kriya Yoga tradition, we have quite a number of very ancient scriptures like Patanjali Yoga Sutra, by the way, Bhagavad Gita, and Jnana Sankalin Tantra, and Vijnana Bhairav Tantra. These are all names, lots of ancient scriptures. Well, unfortunately or fortunately, I don't know, but if you read that books, even in English or in Russian language, in German language, they're available in all languages.
You won't understand.
Yeah, you need extra explanations about meaning, about everything, what is the message about, etc. But we have a modern literature as well. And the most famous book is written by Yogananda Paramahamsa. 1946 he published this book, and the title is Autobiography of a Yogi. And this is the most famous book about Kriya Yoga, but there is no explanation about techniques there.
So you need to go to gurus.
You need to take part in any master class, seminar, workshop. And actually, I'm author of a number of books. Actually, at the moment, I published three books about Kriya Yoga. As I mentioned, at the moment, they publish in Russian, but I'm planning to translate it and publish it in English. But you know what can we give? What kind of information can we give in the books? Just the stories or philosophy.
All right.
Techniques it's not possible to describe in the books because you have to learn them during some classes, let us say. Because, actually I'm trying to make videos and put them on YouTube, etc. But even if you take my videos or somebody's videos with the techniques, you know, it's like more like general information, because hundreds of details, which anyway you had to learn during the program, like workshop, seminar, or master classes. And actually, when I write books, I like to give more and more stories, because you see, if you read books which is like purely philosophical, actually it's a little bit borrowed, difficult to give
it's maybe not it's so boring, but it's really difficult to understand when you don't have practical evidence.
But the stories are really important to grasp the meaning. So that's reason why all my books mostly like, you know, a little bit philosophy than most stories. For example, that books which I published about Kriya Yoga, mostly it's a stories about my guru Yogi Rama, his life. Stories how I spent years with him, his spiritual instructions. By the way, he's a supernatural power as well. And you know, sometimes people read my books and say, no, we can't believe it's outside of our comfort zone that you are speaking about such miracles, which are just impossible.
Yeah.
I'm okay about that. Okay, you know, if you read New Testament, you also may believe or not that Jesus done
seems
all
unbelievable,
that. Unbelievable, yeah. But anyway, the spiritual message is there, but in the form of stories. So it means if you ask me about books, of course the greatest book about Kriya Yoga is Autobiography of a Yogi by Yogananda. It's a global...
But it's not a Bible, it's just a...
We don't have a Kriya Yoga Bible because we're not religious tradition.
Yeah, yeah,
we're just.
I mean, the Bible like something to follow, like a guidance, and when you could open and learn.
I think I'm afraid we don't have such a one book.
All right.
And by the way,
that was the question.
I mean,
if you wanna be involved, you need to go to these workshops to...
And you have to be free person. This is the most awful for most of the people. You have to be free person. I mean to say, if you are Christian, means for you, the main guidance goes from New Testament. Somebody
yeah, but now, nowadays it's really difficult to be a free person, you know, because you have to be really... your soul has to be really strong to be free person.
Yeah, you have to be strong.
To be free of all these limits and all these frames that we have. It's really difficult.
Yeah. But anyway, I encourage people to be free, and sometimes people even ask me.
If you give people an instrument to free themselves, it will be great.
No, you see, it's more like not... the instrument is meditation, but to be free means... you know, if you take the very famous thing, if you take five people with whom you are always communicating like right now in your life, these five people will construct your life next year. I mean, who are your friends? You will be the same like quite soon. And it means if you will communicate with the free thinking people, people who are practicing meditation, they are positive, they are trying, at least trying to be free. It means you will be free. And no techniques which may lead you to freedom. Techniques is a meditation. Techniques is the, physical exercises. By the way, I'm teaching not only Kriya Yoga, but a little bit Qigong, the Chinese physical exercises. But, you know, to be free is a question of your insight, understanding. And to get it, you have to read proper books, you have to communicate with the proper people, positive and the free-oriented people. So, I think we are living in a time when we have greatest chance to be free. Just imagine what was in Russia, for example, 50 years back. Yeah, it was communist ideology, and to be free like 50 years back, oh, not possible, you know, 100 years, 200, it was very difficult. But now we have a chance, an opportunity to choose to receive that kind of information which we wish, and it's not the best time to be free.
All right. This on this note.
On this note, we can complete. Thank you very much.
Thank you.